Great. Thank you very much for the organizers. My name is Ehsan Sedaghat-Nejad. I'm a PhD student at Shadmehr Lab at Johns Hopkins University. The work that I'm going to present for you today is a collaboration with my colleagues, Paul Hage and JP, also PhD student at Shadmehr Lab. The title of the talk is Control of Movement Deceleration by the Purkinje Cells of the Cerebellum. So let's first start with the sample patients that have cerebellar degeneration along dorsal vermis. And as you can see at the end of the eye movements, there's these jittery extra movements. If you look at the traces of the eye movement, we can see that these patients indeed can initiate the movement, in this case, eye movement, but they have difficulty controlling the endpoint accuracy of their movements. In our lab, we developed protocols to work with marmoset monkeys, and we are using marmoset monkeys to study cerebellum in general, and in specific, study Purkinje cells of the cerebellum and how the Purkinje cells of the cerebellum contribute to an ongoing movement. We also developed a software package named PSort to sort the cerebral neurophysiological data and a specific sort complex spikes of the Purkinje cells. Our task consists of two saccades, a primary saccade and a secondary saccade. The primary saccade can be in one of eight random directions. The secondary saccade can also be in one of eight random directions. And while the monkey is doing this saccadic task, we are recording from oculomotor region of the cerebellum, lobule 7A in marmosets. And later, using the PSort software, we sorted the simple spikes and complex spike activity of the cerebral Purkinje cells. If you look at the activity of Purkinje cells during the saccades, here's the saccade onset, what we will see is that the estimated simple spike firing rate of the Purkinje cells do indeed show modulation for saccades, but the activity is complex, so it is complicated, and there is no emerging pattern of activity for the simple spike. However, since we also sorted the complex spike, if you look at the complex spike activity, what we will see is that, first of all, there are sparse, but if you look at the probability of getting a complex spike after the target jump and before the saccade onset, what we will see is that the complex spike activities show a tuning and a preference for a direction. So what we are going to do is that we are going to use this CS tuning, and we are going to redefine our absolute coordinate system, and we are going to make a new relative coordinate system based on CS on. Using this new coordinate system, what we will see is that the CS firing activity of over 138 P cells show an increase in the firing rate in the direction CS on. Well, that's by definition, that's the definition of CS on. But what we didn't control for is the direction CS180. And what we saw is that in direction CS180, the activity of P cell CS firing rate will actually go below the baseline. Well, that's great, but how can this help us understand the SS population response? Before showing you the population results, let me first show you how diverse is the activity of P cells. So we have P cells that are bursting during the saccade activity, cells that are bursting, pausing, pausing, bursting, or even completely pausing during the saccade. And in all these examples, the activity of the cells lasts much longer than the saccade offset. So how does this Purkinje cells contribute to the endpoint accuracy of an ongoing eye movement if the activity lasts much longer than the saccade itself? Well, to answer that question, we used our relative coordinate system based on the CS tuning, and we looked at the population response of all of our 138 Purkinje cells in the direction CS180. And what we found is that the SS firing of the population activity show a burst in activity, which predicts acceleration of eye movement, and a pause during deceleration phase of the eye movement. And this pause will precisely predict the end of the eye movement. More importantly, we also in our data set have 36 pairs of simultaneously recorded Purkinje cell. And if you look at the synchronization between between a pair of Purkinje cells, what we found is that during the acceleration phase, although we had a burst in activity, but we don't have any increased synchronization. However, during the deceleration phase of the eye movement that we had the pausing activity, we actually see a higher synchronization in the pairs of Purkinje cells, which is kind of counterintuitive. Well, overall, our results show that if we organize P cells into populations based on CS tuning, then the SS firing rate will show activity that will predict the end location of the eye movement and the duration of eye movement. And more importantly, if you look at the synchronization between the Purkinje cells, what we will see is that the activity show a higher synchronization just during the deceleration phase of the eye movement. So all in all, P cells play a significant role in predicting how to end the movement. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And we have a question from Brian. Ehsan, do the relationships you see hold if you look at eye movements made outside of the context of the task, e.g. during the intertrial interval?
Yeah, so actually we looked at, I will be glad to further because I have lots of results that I couldn't put in the 5 minutes, but we see that even for non-task related saccades or task with relevant saccade, we'll see that this tuning will hold. And also, but one more point is that the CS activity will actually, that's what will change for task with relevant saccades. I will be happy to discuss this further.